Okay, next part. 36.19. Experience of promoting family planning amongst employees. But which type of SSC only will get the deduction? Only company. Very important. Revenue, obviously 100%. But capital will be allowed what? 1/5. So it is over okay, a period of 5 years. So type of SSC company. Okay. Section 40. Specific disallowances. Disallowances means expenditure not allowed. Correct. Income tax, TDS, distribution taxes, interest, penalty on it is obviously not allowed. Income tax and TDS, whatever it is, direct taxes are not allowed. Interest penalty on it obviously will also be not allowed. Indirect taxes is allowed as deduction. Then wealth tax, interest penalty on it, again, direct tax not allowed. Tax on non-monetary perquisite paid by an employer not allowed. Correct? Then section 40A, following expenses shall not be allowed while calculating business income. Pay attention. Payment to specified person under section 40A2 in excess of FMV. Very good. In excess of, that means tell me, we are disallowing. We are disallowing whatever is in excess of FMV. So what up to FMV, allowed or not allowed? Up to FMV. Allowed. Yes. Good. Who is specified person?
Individual HUF
form. For the individual. Relatives. Yes or no? Yes. Or any person carrying on business or business profession in which the SSE himself or the relative of the SSE are holding what? At least 20% of profits or voting power. We call it as what? Beneficial interest. You have written it down? No.
Yes.
If the SSE is company former or AOP, HUF, and then what? In that case, the directors, partners, members or relative of directors, partners, members are specified persons. Correct? Okay. For company, any individual having substantial interest with the company. Correct?
Yes.
Or any person with business or profession where the company or the firm, that is the SSE, is having substantial interest. Correct or wrong?
Yes.
Okay. And again, relative is specified over here. Spouse, brothers or sisters. You written somewhere or no? You have written on it in the notebook, I guess. Only relative is what? Spouse, brothers, sisters, or you can say lineal, ascendant or descendant, correct, of the SSE, individual SSE, because relative, no, relative can be only of individual, right, lineal, ascendant and descendant, no? Bloodline. 48.2 was for what? Expenditure in excess of FMV paid to specified person will be disallowed. 48.3, very important. Any expenditure paid or any amount paid to a person in a day exceeding rupees 10,000 through unauthorized mode. What are authorized mode? Account paying check, bank draft or ECS, that's it. Any other payment, even cross check is disallowed. Cross check disallowed and company check disallowed. We want specifically account pay check. Okay, so the limit is what? 10,000, correct? But for transporter,
35,000.
Yes or no? Correct. 48.3a, very important again. When is this case arise? 48.3a. The year of expenditure and year of payment are different years. It can be advance payment, expenditure belongs to next year. It can be earlier or late payment, expenditure is of 1 year, paid in the another year. Correct or wrong? Fine. So when an allowance has been made in the AY for any liability incurred by SSE for any expenditure, allowance has been made means what? It has been allowed as deduction. And during any next year, subsequent means henceforth, the SSE makes payment in respect of that expenditure by unauthorized mode. Yes or no?
Yes.
Then what will happen? We will have to disallow it. Correct or wrong? We will have to disallow in the year of payment. Correct?
Yes.
Okay. So we deem to be as business income. Correct? What was this expenditure of year one and payment also in the same year? Disallowed in year one, obviously. Disallowed. Expenditure of 1 year, but paid in year two by unauthorized mode, then disallowed in year two. Pay attention, very important case. Paid in advance. This is the case of what? Year one paid, but year two expenditure. The expenditure relates to year two. So disallowed in
year two.
Year two or year one? Obviously year two. Yes, everyone. So later, you can say not later, later of above, later of the both the years. Whatever is happening later on. Correct? Fine. Very important. All the exceptions to section 48(3) are mentioned. Those transactions, payment transactions are mentioned in rule 6DD. Very important. You will not disallow under section 48(3) if the payments are done by all of these modes, right? Where payment is made to RBI, SBI, Cooperative Bank, Credit Society, LIC, or the payment is made by modes, which one? Letter of credit, mail, electronic, you can say your money transfers, then book exchange, bill of exchange, ECS also allowed, as well as credit and debit card also allowed. Okay. Then where the payment is made to government and under the rules framed by it, by payment, if such payment is required to be done in cash. I mean payment to government and government requires it in cash, then obviously it is allowed. Yes? Then any adjustment where the payment is made by way of adjustment in the books of account. Then payment is made for the purchase of products. Very important now. Payment is made for the purchase of products from those industries which is not dependent on power. Yes. Where the payment is made in a village or town, which on a date of payment is not served by any bank. So that particular location does not have any
bank.
Correct?
Yes.
Again, very important. Payment is made for purchase of agricultural or forest produce. Yes or no?
Yes.
Then produce of animal husbandry or dairy or poultry farming. Fish or fish products purchased, or even flowers or honeybees. Purchase from the cultivator. Yes or no? The products of horticulture or apiculture. Correct? Grower or producer of such articles, produce or products. Also allowed. Then, payment is made by necessity by way of salary to his employee. What is the expenditure?
Salary.
After deducting tax. It is not paid by authorized mode. Then, still it is allowed as deduction only if it is temporarily posted in a any other place than his normal place of work or on a ship, or does not maintain any account in any bank at such place or ship. Who does not maintain?
Employee.
The employee does not maintain. Yes or no?
Yes.
Very important again. Fine. Then here there is a limit check wherein the payment is made to employee, okay, of the assessee or legal heir by for what? Retirement, retrenchment, resignation, so and so, so and so, so and so. Okay, and the entire amount is paid but not exceeding 50,000. So you have 10,000, 35,000, another limit right now is 50,000. Then when the banks were closed, correct? Then when the payment is made by any person to his agent who is required to make payment
in cash
to another such person, correct? So payment to agent, and agent is required to make payment in cash, so that is also allowed. Then foreign exchange, was it? Check. Where payment is made by an authorized dealer, foreign exchange dealer, for purchase of foreign currency or traveler's check in normal course of his business. Correct or wrong? So giving cash, especially making payment of cash. Who is the person? He is the dealer of foreign exchange. It is allowed to him. Yes?
Yes.
43B, another very, very important section. It is an expenditure of a year, of the year. It is maybe already booked in your books of accounts, already debited maybe, or provision is done. But it will be allowed as deduction in income tax only if it is actually paid on or before 1391 ROI due date. Very important. There is a time period of almost 6 months. Your books close on 31st March. And your ROI due date, usually if it is audit case, then it is September. Are you following? So you still have that time period. Clear or not? Okay, so check. Following sums will be allowed only if it is paid on or before 1391 for that particular year. 43B considers only specific items. So 43B is applicable only on certain expenditures. If it is not part of 43B, there is no disallowance under 43B. Whether paid, unpaid, no, you can say, connection at all. Clear? So 43B you will be disallowing only if it is unpaid. And it covers that particular expenditure. Clear? Okay. Tax duty, cess or fee under any law for time being in force. That means if you, let us say, show provision taxes to be paid, but did not pay till 1391, then disallow. Clear or not? Then. Employer's contribution to any fund or superannuation fund or provident fund or gratuity fund or any other fund for the purpose of welfare of employees. Again, you just have shown it as provision. So in the immediate, you can see competition, maybe you'll disallow. Let us say if at all you're doing competition in the month of April after the end of the financial year or previous year. But you still have time up to September, turn it around. So you still have that time, and if in that time you make the actual payment, then again it is allowed. So 43B, I think I've told you, it is not a permanent disallowance. It is maybe disallowed in 1 year, so obviously it will be allowed in the year of actual payment. Very good. This we already covered your check. If not paid and is allowed, it is not permanent disallowance. We will allow it in the year of actual payment. So there may arise a case that in the earlier years there was disallowance in 43B, but in the current year that particular payment is done, you have to allow it. You have to allow it. Very good. Bonus commission payable to employees. 43B applicable. Provision disallow, actual payment allow. Interest on loan. You are paying what? Or making provision for interest to be paid. But you have taken loan from whom? Public financial institution means your bank. Or state financial corporation. Or state industrial investment corporation. Blah, 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 blah. Or cooperative bank. Other than. But which cooperative bank is allowed? Any cooperative bank other than primary agricultural rent society or primary cooperative agricultural and rural development bank. Correct or wrong? So again, interest on loan is covered under section 43B. Specific banks, okay? Leave encashment provision disallow, allow again it on payment basis. And any sum payable to Indian Railways for the use of railway assets. Clear or wrong? Are you following? Okay. Then, repayment of interest, very important. Conversion of due or payable interest into new loan is not repayment of interest. Old pending interest is converted as shown as new loan. That doesn't mean the interest is actually paid. We don't give him deduction for the same. Clear or wrong? If old loan is converted into new loan, the new loan principle is what? It is pending interest on old loan. Remembering or no?
Yes.
Old loan principle interest, remember? We allow interest reduction. Clear? If interest is pending of old loan, then we have converted into new loan. The new loan principle is nothing but old loan's interest. Clear or not? Okay. Then contribution to provident and other fund, important 3614 and 3615. Check. Employer's contribution. Whose expenditure?
Employer's
expenditure. To employees' provident fund and other funds are allowed as deduction only if in case of certain cases. The fund is set up upon a particular trust. That means it is basically, it also has to be recognized. Correct or wrong? It has to be recognized or approved. And obviously it has to be for exclusive benefit of the employee. This condition has to be followed. Then employer's contribution is allowed as a deduction. Not a problem. But employee's contribution. Who contributes in the employee's fund? Employer is contributing means he will deduct from the salary of employee. And he, along with the matching contribution of himself, will put it in the fund. Clear or not? So once he deducts from the salary of the employee, it is added in his income. Clear or not? Then when do we allow it as deduction? When it is paid before the due date. Provident fund due date, if you remember.
Yes.
The funds due date, check. So when it is deducted from employee salary, it is added in the income. Deduction will be allowed only if the such sum is credited to the employee's fund on or before due date, not 139(1) due date, the provident fund due date. Clear? Very important. We have done questions also based on this. Fine. Then ATCCD 36(1)(4)A. Employer's contribution. Whose contribution? Whose expenditure? Employer himself own contribution to pension fund under section ATCCD, your NPS up to. You may contribute 12, 15, 20%, doesn't matter. You will be allowed deduction of 10% only. Shall be allowed as deduction. Salary includes DA. If forms part of employment, of employment, not retirement. But excludes all other allowances and perquisites forming part of retirement benefits. We have seen, we have done question on this also.
Yes.
Correct? Balance contribution is disallowed under section 48.9. So if contributed 12%, 2% will be disallowed under 48.9 and 10% is allowed under 36(1)(4)(a). Correct? Contribution where? To National Pension Scheme mentioned under section ATCCD. Correct? 48.7. Gratuity. Provision for gratuity?
Disallowed.
Gratuity actually paid during the year is allowed as?
Deduction.
Correct or wrong?
Yes.
Then gratuity actually paid during the year allowed as deduction. And employers contribution to approved gratuity fund obviously is also allowed as
deduction,
not an issue. But provision we do not allow. Then 48.9. No deduction will be allowed in respect of any sum paid by assessee as an employer towards setting up of formation or contribution of any fund, trust or company, but which is not required under any law. So any, you can say hobbies or any skills or any time pass clubs which are created by employees, over there if employer is contributing, because that was not required under law, so it will not be allowed as deduction. Okay. Payment to employees allowed as deduction only if paid before ROI due date. Leave encashment, bonus or commission, employer's contribution to gratuity or provident fund are accepted. This we have actually already seen in 43B. Actually paid means what? All these funds, whatever the amounts that they are paid to the particular PE, no. PE are what? Either the fund or the employee, correct? Then, payment to employees allowed as deduction even if not paid before ROI due date. Basic salary, allowances, perquisites, pension as well as retrenchment compensation, correct? So, separate disallowances only for if not paid before ROI due date, leave encashment, bonus or commission or employee's contribution to the gratuity or provident funds. Provision of gratuity, again, not allowed. Remember, no?
Yes.
Next one, most important, TDS. There are two types of non-compliance for TDS. Non-deduction or non-payment. Obviously, if not deducted, the concept arises of non-payment. Yes or no? There can also be concept of deducted but not paid. Very good. That is, in fact, more dangerous because you are holding someone else's money. Correct? So, check. TDS is deductible at source means TDS was liable and TDS was either not done or done but not paid. Paid to Government of India. Remember, good has not been paid on or before 139(1) due date. Very important. TDS has to be done during the year. TDS has to be done during the year. You may still pay on or before ROI due date. Very important. So TDS do it before 31st March. But you can pay to the government up to 139(1) due date of that year. Remember or no?
Yes.
Okay, so tell me, deducted during the year, paid during the year. Any disallowance?
No.
Deducted during the year, paid before ROI due date. No disallowance, still allowed. Deducted after the year, disallowed. Even if you deducted on the next year, 1st April, you have gone the year ahead.
Yes.
That will be disallowed. Are you following or no? Very important. Understood or no? So this deduction has to be done during the year. If it misses even by one single day, doesn't matter, it will be disallowed. Correct? But again, is it permanent disallowance?
No.
It is just like 43B. Disallowed first, but again allowed in the year of payment. Clear? Good. Then disallowance is how much? Either 100% or 30%. 100% of the payee is non-receipted. 48.1. And 48.3, sorry, 48.1A, payment to resident, it will be 30%, correct, of the expenditure. This concept also I told you why 100% and 30%. But if the payment is of salaries, payable to who? Check. Either non-resident or payment of salaries done outside India, then it will be what? 100% disallowance, correct? So salaries paid in India will be 40A, 1A, 30%. Salary paid outside India or to non-resident is 40A, 100% disallowance. Clear? Good. Then 37.1, general deduction. It is again a residuary deduction, you can say, or you can disallow under section 37. What is not allowed under section 37? Capital expenditure, first of all, not allowed. Personal expenditure, not allowed, because we say it has to be for wholly and exclusively for the purpose of business. These are the only two important things. Capital not allowed, personal not allowed, and it has to be, there has to be a, without doubt, business connection. Correct? Then we saw some cases, some expenditure are not allowed, very important, CSR, not allowed at all, correct? Any expenditure prohibited by law, not allowed. Then, advertisement or any expenditure or political party advertisement, not allowed. Direct taxes as it is, we don't allow, interest on it also, not allowed. Indirect taxes, allowed, subject to 43B. Interest allowed, penalty, not allowed. Interest can be compensated by paying something more. Penalty, no. Provident fund or ESI contribution, again 43B. Interest also allowed, penalty not allowed. But if it is for a particular contract, then it is allowed. Even penalty is allowed as deduction because you are into that particular contract. It is, you are not breaking the law, you are only breaking the private contract. So it is allowed as deduction. Clear? Fine. Fine.